News Review from BBC Learning English.
Hello and welcome to News Review, the programme where we give you the words and phrases you need to talk about the news. Hi, I'm Sian, and with me in the studio today is Catherine. Hi, Catherine.
Hello, Sian.
What story do you have for us today?
Today, Sian, I've brought you a very dirty story.
Ooh, a dirty story. Yes. Let's hear more about this story.
With just 4 days until the start of the Olympic Games in Brazil, reports indicate that levels of pollution in Rio de Janeiro remain alarmingly high. Guanabara Bay, where sailing events will be held, is heavily polluted by raw sewage and chemicals. Research also suggests the authorities have failed in their promise to clean up Rio's air quality.
So the Rio Olympics are due to start in 4 days, and the waterway where the sailing event will be happening is extremely polluted, and people are very worried about this.
Oh dear. And you've been looking at the story in the news. What words and phrases have you picked out today?
Okay, so yes, this story is being picked up by a lot of the world's media, and three words that keep popping up are filthy, teeming with, and unfazed.
Okay, so filthy, that means very, very dirty or unpleasant. Teeming with, meaning containing a large number of. And unfazed, meaning not surprised or worried. So how are these stories appearing in the news?
OK, so we've got, first of all, we'll look at filthy. And Yahoo News website tells us that the waterways of Rio de Janeiro are as filthy as ever. And we also have on CBS Sports website, they're talking about pollution in the air as well as the water in Rio, and they say, their headline says, polluted Rio air more dangerous for Olympians than filthy water.
Okay, so they're saying the air and the water are both very, very dirty.
Unfortunately, according to this report, that's what they're saying. So yeah, filthy means very, very dirty. Dirty in the way that it's actually disgusting.
Right.
It's horrible. It makes you feel ill. It's just extreme dirt that's very, with disgusting in some way. Yeah.
Oh, so as well as water and air, can we use it to talk about other things? So if I don't clean my kitchen for a few weeks, can I say, oh, my kitchen is filthy?
Sian, I'm sure your kitchen is absolutely spotless. But if but if you didn't clean it for some reason, you couldn't clean your kitchen for months and months and months, I'm sure it would be filthy, disgusting, smelly, horrible. Yes, yes, yes.
Okay, I'll make sure that I don't let it get in that situation.
I won't be coming around to dinner anytime soon.
I've also heard a filthy mind as well. So
yes,
obviously slightly different.
Yes, it's about, you know, filthy is often for things, but it can also be for ideas or the way people think. So if you have, you know, for somebody who's really kind of unpleasant, does horrible things, makes people feel uncomfortable, tells rude jokes, inappropriate behaviour, you can say that person has a filthy mind. Yeah, he thinks in a horrible way. Yeah.
Okay, and is it always quite negative, or can we use it in a more light-hearted way?
We can, yes. And in the context of this story, filthy water, it's dangerous and horrible. It's definitely negative. But yeah, if your kids are out playing and they come home all dirty, you can say, you're filthy, get a shower. So you can use it, yeah, in a light-hearted way. Telling your friend off for being a bit rude, you can say, well, you've got a filthy mind.
Yes.
So you choose the way, the degree of negativity for the situation.
Okay. Yeah. And it's extreme, so obviously we need to use absolutely or completely. We can't use very with this adjective.
You don't say very filthy. It's absolutely filthy or completely filthy. Yeah.
Okay.
Extreme adjective.
Great. And how about the next word that you found in the news?
Yep. Next word is team. With, and it's in the Yahoo headline again, and it says that the waterways of Rio de Janeiro are contaminated with raw human sewage, teeming with dangerous viruses and bacteria. So not very pleasant at all. And the word teeming with is full of, containing a lot of things, usually living things.
Okay, so can we use it for people, animals as well as bacteria?
Yeah, you're in the shopping centre, it's a Saturday afternoon, it's teeming with people. And mm-hmm. if I ever go to your unclean kitchen,
your filthy kitchen,
it will be teeming with bugs and teeming with rats and cockroaches.
Yeah.
Yes. So lots and lots of living things in a place, yeah.
Okay, great. Well, not great. How about the third word you found?
This third one, unfazed, and we have it in the Guardian website, Australians unfazed by water pollution at Rio Olympics rowing course.
Mm, so they're not worried, they're not surprised.
Not bothered, no. Nope. If you're unfazed by a problem, mm-hmm. it means you've got a plan, there's a problem, but you don't care about the problem, you're doing it anyway. It doesn't bother you. Go ahead, keep going. There's no problem. So if you're in your filthy kitchen cooking your dinner anyway,
unfazed by the kitchen.
Unfazed by the dirty kitchen. It means you don't care about a problem. Keep going. Business as usual.
Okay, so I'm going to the beach this weekend. The weather forecast says it's going to rain.
Oh.
But I'm unfazed by this. I'm going to go anyway.
Have fun in the rain.
I will do. Okay, great. Let's hear a little bit more about this story from Brazil correspondent Wyre Davies.
Cleaning up Rio's chronically polluted waters was a promise that the city made when it was chosen to host the Olympic Games. But it simply hasn't been kept. We're out now on Guanabara Bay, where Olympic sailing events will take place. The smell from the oil on the surface is overpowering. And these are waters full of physical waste, furniture, even dead animals have been found in the water here. But most of all, it's the sewage from the favelas and even the middle-class parts of town that floods down into the bay, making this one of the world's most polluted waterways.
Okay, so that was Wyre Davies telling us about the filthy water he is experiencing. As we said, the Australian rowers are unfazed by this. And on Facebook, we asked you to tell us an idiom that when somebody is calm, relaxed and not worried about something. So do we say they are as cool as a coconut, B, cucumber or C, carrot? What responses have we had for this question, Catherine?
Well, our Facebook audience were unfazed by this question and gave us hundreds of answers. Quite a lot of you said cool as a coconut, which unfortunately is the wrong answer. In English, we say when somebody isn't bothered about something, they're relaxed and comfortable, they are as cool as a cucumber. So well done to everyone who got that one right. We have, to name a few, Arisha Mirza, Majid Asadi, Sarah Marad and May De La Cruz all got it correct. Well done, everyone.
Well done. And finally, Catherine, can you recap the words we've heard today, please?
I can. We had filthy, which means very, very dirty. We had teeming with, which means containing a large number of usually living things. And our third word was unfazed, which means not surprised or worried.
Excellent. And we hope that you are unfazed by all of these new words and phrases. You can visit our website, bbclearningenglish.com, to find out more about this story. Thanks for joining us and see you again next week. Goodbye.
Bye.
News review from BBC Learning English.